to open a browser window. It's time to put on your favorite pants. Log into Twitter, put your headphones on, and dance, dance, dance. Block out the world for 65 minutes or more. Put a sign on your office door. Cause DoubleClicks Live for this month is about to start. About to start now. DoubleClicks, DoubleClicks, DoubleClicks Live is a free show and you don't have to drive. Sing along, meet the guests. It's almost time for DoubleClicks, 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 DoubleClicks Live. Hello, everybody. Welcome to DoubleClicks Live. We have an amazing show for you tonight. A bunch of shows based on your requests from Facebook. You can request shows for next month on Facebook now in the link in the description, but it's too late to request songs for this show. And we've got a special guest. PDX Broadsides will be joining us in about halfway through the show. So thank you so much for tuning in. Alrighty. It's all happening. We've got somebody watching the chat for us, so if you have a question, go ahead and drop it in there, and we will maybe answer it at some point. Looks like we've got friends from the UK. Paul is here. Darren, Scott, Emily. Hi, Emily. Crow, Ghoul, Josh, Class, Abraham, Dover, the Fifth Sister. Look at all of these wonderful people. Mark with a C is here.
Hi, Mark.
Holly Anna, of course. Yes, yay. We've got the Broadsides. So thank you so much for joining us. Please feel free to chat with each other. There's lots of fun emojis. And we have so many songs to play.
Hooray.
We'll just hop right in.
Start playing the songs.
We've had a good month since the last time we were here. Let's see, last time it was Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
And now we've got eggs.
Eggs.
Because it's
Easter.
Oh, I wasn't gonna guess. Because it's Easter, which I literally forgot about.
Maybe.
Yeah, no, because it's egg holiday.
Egg holiday.
We're also going to be announcing later in the show. Oh, that was weird. Why did I do that with my eyes? We're going to be announcing our tour dates for the summer. So that'll be fun. Is everybody okay? Is the sound okay? Yeah, awesome.
Yay.
Cool. There's kitties.
Kitties.
Heather's here.
Hello,
it's going to be party time.
Party time.
I've got a lion on my shirt. And a little, this is from Paul, I think. This is D8. Okay. So let's hop on in. This first song was requested by many people, including Helen Jones, who has a lightsaber in her picture.
Oh, yeah.
So I assume is a Jedi. I was in Colorado.
Yes.
This week, and we were at this fancy park with pretty rocks. I think that's what it was called. Fancy Park with Pretty Rocks.
Fancy Park, Pretty Rocks.
And there was a little girl there running around. And she had a lightsaber. There were two little girls with lightsabers and there were two little boys. And one of the girls kept going, I'm Leia and I have a lightsaber. So it was really great. So that was awesome. So it may have been Helen Jones. I don't know. She seemed too young to be on Facebook. I think you're supposed to be 13, but. And this is a song about loving things that you want to love and also breakfast.
Yay.
Let's hope the sound works. I like to eat toast with jam. You like to eat eggs and ham. And if you're N, we can be friends, cause I don't have a problem with ham, cause eggs ham. I like to wear sweaters and skirts too. I like to do just what I want to. And if you don't like what I do with my life, well that's great, cause I didn't ask you. This is my jam. This is my jam. This is my toast. This is my knife. And this is my jam. This is my jam. This is my jam. This is my song. This is my life. And this is my jam. I'm gonna do this if you don't wanna do this. I'm gonna find somebody who wants to do this. Cause I am a person, and if you are a person, you should want what you want, long as nobody's hurting. You're not gonna tell me the songs I should write, and you're not gonna tell me my clothes are too tight. Cause I've gotta love doing all my own stuff, and that love's gotta come from inside. This is my jam. This is my jam. This is my toast. This is my knife. And this is my jam. This is my jam. This is my jam. This is my song. This is my life. And this is my jam. I'd like to be eating breakfast with people that I like, with no one telling me the things they think I should do with my life. And like John Green tells us to imagine others complexly, I won't judge you, cause what you like has nothing to do with me. I'd like to be eating breakfast with people that I like, with no one telling me the things they think I should do with my life. And like John Green tells us to imagine others complexly, I won't judge you, cause what you like has nothing to do with me. This is my jam, this is my toast, this is my life, and this is my jam. This is my jam, this is my jam, this is my song, this is my life, and this is my jam.
Sounds good.
That was us.
I'm just watching a video over here. There's these this band. They're on the internet right now. I'm just keeping an eye on it.
They're singing about breakfast.
Yeah.
Sweet.
People are talking about things. Everything okay, Gary? We got our secret moderator. I just said his name, so that wasn't helpful.
No one heard that.
Great. Okay. I'm so happy. Somebody named Skya is here. That's cool. And a robot.
Ooh.
A superior robot.
Oh.
Thank you for being here. Sweet. Where are you all watching from? I know some of you said already. Tell each other. Big hello from Miami University. Hi. Oh my God. We had such a good time there. Wonderful, wonderful. Lucia is here. Oh, Lucia. Hi.
Hi, Lucia.
I miss you. I haven't seen you in like 5 days. It's the worst. If you guys don't know, Lucia and I have a web series called Catty Bees.
There's cats.
You can go to cattybees.com or subscribe. We finally got our unique YouTube URL, so Ooh. You can subscribe at youtube.com/cattybees. Just like maybe open another window and do that real fast. It's a really, really fun web series that we made. Aubrey is now our official production everything.
I do some things.
She does all the stuff. And we talk about, we just got some good tips. Tips on how to be a person by two women who are mostly interested in cats and nothing else. So I definitely recommend checking that out. And Lucia's here. Hi.
Brian Tachowski is here.
Ah! Yeah. Denver. Oh, I was just in Denver. It was so snowy. I went to Denver for vacation and a break to see They Might Be Giants because they aren't coming to Portland on this tour and their show got snowed out.
No!
It was so sad, but I had a really good time the day that it was snowing. We spent the whole time inside and we played three board games and I won two of them. So
well done.
Yeah. I like won one of them by a lot, which is wonderful. I think we figured out because this person I'm dating usually wins games.
Yeah.
And so people usually target them to like bring them down because they're like, this person is going to win.
Yeah.
Which makes me win like all the time I play games now, which is pretty great. Although now that I've said that out loud, it probably won't work anymore, but. That's what's going on. Oh, yay. Okay. So the next song was requested by a lot of people.
Yay.
And it's super appropriate. Probably you guys knew this. This is our Wonder Woman song because the Wonder Woman movie featuring Batman just came out. I haven't seen it. There's not that much Wonder Woman, is it?
She's there.
Yeah.
It's great. It's like, oh, she looks really interesting. Why isn't, okay. I'll just wait for the next movie.
Yeah, I think that's the goal, is that you're supposed to go and be like, I want more Wonder Woman. I guess I'll wait for the next movie, but that's not coming for a while.
Nope. But yeah. When she's there, it's great. She's like real good at fighting.
Yeah.
Did you know that?
That's good. She's strong. Strong and powerful.
More than just strong.
Great. More than just strong.
Yes.
I'm writing down something to remind myself later.
Okay.
Except that it's just going to look like chords. All right, it'll be fine. Okay, yeah, so this is our song about Wonder Woman suggested by Michael and a whole bunch of other people. Thank you, Michael, and a whole bunch of other people.
Yay!
For such a topical song suggestion. Oh, I don't have to wear those.
Yeah, you don't have to wear those. There they go. It's so easy to maneuver in the studio. The Doubleclicks,
we really know what we're doing. Okay, here we go. They're talking about Wonder Woman. I just want to watch the chat and talk about Wonder Woman.
Should.
You guys keep talking about Wonder Woman, and I will play music.
You do your job.
I'll do my job. You do yours. I'll go back and watch it later. Here we go.
leaving home for the first time. You never knew the deals could be so dirty. You'd never seen so many lies. People hurting out from the inside. You have the strength to save us. You have the power to know right from wrong, to spread the truth and set the unsteady. But men in dark suits tell you people aren't ready. But you're not a quitter. You still believe the truth's in your lasso. Your heart's on your sleeve, and when we're drowning in darkness, you'll save us all from going under. And we'll watch you in wonder. Welcome to the dirty world, tell you being strong is not for girls. They'll say that your values being easy on the eyes. Crush those people to death with your thighs. Men in power aren't who you care about. The city's pain stops when you bring the truth out. Though your sisters may tell you mankind can't be saved, you know that inside the weak can be brave. And you're not a quitter. You still believe the truth's in your lasso. Your heart's on your sleeve. And when we're drowning in darkness, you'll save us all from going under. And we'll watch you in wonder. When they send you away, you know they'll never forget. And you'll hover above in your invisible jet. When they finally want you, they'll call you back down. Pull on your hot pants and put on your crown. You're not a quitter. You still believe the truth's in your lasso. Your heart's on your sleeve. And when we're drowning in darkness, you'll save us all from going under. And we'll watch you in wonder.
We are getting word from the chat that a lot of people love the Pink Lion.
Isn't it beautiful?
Tell us about the Pink Lion, Aubrey.
This is Pink Lion, which was, I got at the GamerX, which was so great. And Hannah Diaz was there to sell me this print that she made of the lion from Steven Universe. Isn't it beautiful? And it's got Rose Quartz sword coming out, like they do in Steven Universe.
The other,
it makes me so happy.
Wonderful piece of art on this wall. Hold on. I'm going to move this. Is it going to be terrible?
Where? Oh, move this. Yeah, go for it. Should be fine.
Horrible noises. Is this? Is the Velociraptor? The Velociraptor is sad. What does Angela say to cheer him up? Yo, they got like 30 kinds of Oreos now. That's my favorite one that we've gotten. And that was from Carrie, who's here right now. Oh, by the way, everybody, look at my Star Wars
skirt.
It's got the Millennium bird on it.
Yeah, that bird.
Millennium Eagle.
It's such a cool skirt. I love it so much.
Falcon. Yeah, sorry for moving the camera. It's back. Get over it.
I'm over it.
Does it still reverse? I can't tell. Yay. Oh, this skirt's from ThinkGeek, by the way.
Yeah.
We were like, we want Star Wars clothes. I wonder if ThinkGeek will send us some if we talk about them a bunch.
Thank you, ThinkGeek.
And it worked. cashing in on the sweet Twitter followers. They make amazing things, and they make things in lady sizes, and they make things in lady sizes that aren't just tiny. How great is that?
Yeah.
We go like this about it. Okay, we gotta play more songs because we have a guest.
Oh, yeah.
So this is a relatively new song. I was really happy that people voted for us to play this one because I like it and it's new. It's not. Do we keep doing this?
You keep moving this way.
Oh.
Yeah. Like, he doesn't want to stay over there. It's okay.
I just want to be where the people are. I want to be in the room where it happens.
It's okay.
This is a song that we wrote about science. About the kilogram standard,
yeah.
La Grande K, if you don't know, it's a piece of tungsten and other metals that they use to measure what a kilogram is, like the standard of a kilogram. But of course, it's only a physical object, so it changes. Like over the last 120 years, like molecules and stuff like that has made it way slightly different than other kilogram standards that they made a replica of it. So they've been trying to replace it with just a mathematical formula using the atomic weight of silicon and stuff like that. Anyway, I've read a lot of articles and partially understood them and mostly just say some of the words that I remember. And so we wrote a song that is sort of a breakup song from Kilogram to the scientific community who are abandoning her for science and math. And the song is called Kilogram. Oh, it is dedicated to Aaron Steiner.
Hi, Aaron.
Who is one of the people who requested this. It started physical, but there's no shame there. I was what you needed, and I was happy to stay there. You said I was your constant, your ideal. And I started to think that the thing we had was real. Days turned into years right in front of our eyes. You kept me locked up here, I felt like a prize. You said I was the best you had, and I clung to your word. I wanted to be what you needed, and for you I was standard. I was lost for so long, but you showed me who I am. I could never be wrong if I was your kilogram. But now it's all over if your calculations are correct. I'm more than a number, and that is why we are wrecks. I know it makes sense, I know you have needs. But what do I do now? What about me? Could you really replace me with nothing but numbers? I suppose that you can. But who will I be if I'm not your kilogram? I'm searching for meaning in your eyes, but they're blank. There is somebody else, I know it, somebody named Plank. I know it makes sense, it's logic, it's smart, but I did nothing wrong. Do you not have a heart? Would you let a committee of strangers tell you who I really am? And will you really be you without your kilogram? Kilogram. You've been listening to the Doubleclicks Live. That was Kilogram by the Doubleclicks off of their forthcoming EP, which you don't know about yet. What if that was what we did? I don't like that at all. I'm sorry.
That was the kilogram,
it keeps you grounded without weighing you down. Look at you guys.
Yay! Yay!
Plank is a constant disappointment. You guys. Darren. You guys. You're just so delightful. And I love you all so much. How is the latency? I know last time we were having a lot of buffering issues. Let us know. Is it a thing? Is people are talking about it a little bit? 15 seconds behind. Oh, yeah, the lag is fine. Last time it was just pausing and buffering a lot. Yeah, it doesn't seem to be doing that. We fixed it using, we did some stuff. So you're welcome, technology.
Thank you, technology.
Okay. We should probably do, oh gosh, we have so much fun stuff to go on.
Yay!
We're going to do this song now. This was requested on the chat by Craig Steffen, who has been doing apparently some deep digging into the past of the Doubleclicks, because this is
the archives.
We have not played in a long time, and I was looking at it today while we were rehearsing. I was like, wow, this is a weird one. I'm glad. It's another kind of science song, like the one we just played, which is cool.
We actually, I think, if it's okay to say, we consulted a scientist who is going to be on the show later to write this song.
That's true.
Yes.
Yeah, Jessica, that's true. So this was, we wrote in 2012. We were doing something called Song Foo 2012, wherein Kim Plume from a site called Fred.com and a bunch of other people gave us song prompts. And every month we had to write a song from this song prompt. Mm-hmm. And this one was, we were instructed to write a song about bioluminescence. And so we wrote this song, which is from the perspective of a woman whose parents spliced green fluorescent protein into her DNA as a sort of trying to make her a super person. And it didn't do a whole lot other than it kind of makes her eyes and nose and mouth glow, because that would be what would happen if you spliced that into a person. Like, it wouldn't make all of you glow, just like the parts of you that have like the thin. Anyway, it's weird. It's a very specific story that is not true or from anything. So I hope you enjoy it. This is a song. Oh, yeah. Somebody just wrote. Okay. Anyway, don't look at the chat while you're in the middle of a sentence. And this is a song called The Way I Glow. Okay. Oh, yeah. And okay. What I was saying before I got distracted by the chat is that she has this mutation and she blames all of the problems in her life on this one setback that she can blame on somebody else, which is
her parents.
Her parents. So it's a, I don't know, it's sort of like a relatable feeling that I was projecting. Who even knows? I do. and so that's what this song is about. It's called The Way I Glow. It's a love song. Here we go. It's a loud and crowded party, and it's so dark that people find it hard to see. But I can clearly tell that you're avoiding me. I catch you at last, and I finally try asking why you left without saying goodbye. But you shield your gaze from the light emitting from my mouth and eyes. I just want to love you, but you can't see me for who I am. You'll never look past my appearance and into my soul. I could be there for you, and I'd make you proud. You were my man, and you might learn to like the way I glow. They call me a failed experiment of science. They say my parents didn't know what they were trying. But maybe I'm just more involved. Think of the problems GFB can solve. You say my DNA is not the issue.
It's not.
You pretend this is a regular fight.
You're not listening.
But what does she have that I don't? Except a visage without light. At the end of the night, when I order my drink, people stare at me there, and I start to think, this must be what it was like to be the missing link. I just want to love you, but you can't see me for who I am. You'll never look past my mutations and into my soul. I could be there for you, and I'd make you proud if you were my man. And you might learn to like the way I glow. You might learn to like the way I glow.
The way I glow.
Yay.
Yay.
That's been so long since we played that song. Thank you for requesting it.
Thank you for requesting it. Fox's Tidbit said, I feel like this girl should meet the boy from Bioluminescent Boy. Bioluminescent Boy is a song by Molly Lewis that was written for the exact same project.
Oh my God.
We didn't even know we wrote them and they should fall in love. Anyway, check out Molly Lewis's song, Bioluminescent
it's
Boy.
It's so good.
We have so many plugs, you guys. We're going to keep telling you to check stuff out. Everything except that thing I just said is in the description of this video. We've got all kinds of projects and stuff that we want to tell you about. One of the ones I want to tell you about right now before we play one more song and then call in our guest. You hear that, guest? We have one more song and then we're going to say click the button, and then you click the button. Don't click it yet.
Nope.
But click it when this next song is over.
Yes.
Okay. Oh God, I'm so glad we're so organized. I want to tell you about, so we wrote a song, which we're not going to play for you, but called Dangerous Emma.
Yes.
Which is about Emma Goldman, who is one of the five women from history,
we're going to look it up. It's in the description.
Ordinary Women, right.
Yay.
Who Dared to Change History, which is a project by Feminist Frequency that they're funding. They're making mini documentaries with animation, like really high quality stuff about five women who you know, did awesome stuff in history and that you don't hear as much about. So if you check out the link in the description of this video, you can find that site, and also check out the mini song that we wrote about Emma Goldman, who was a anarchist revolutionary, did a lot of stuff, who had a lot of strong opinions, and was awesome and dangerous.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's cool. It's a cool project, and we definitely recommend checking it out. And we're really glad that they asked us to participate in it.
It was really fun.
Yeah.
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 The song and project is rad. Woohoo! What button? If you look in the description of the video, there are links.
Below the video.
Below the video. But you can check those out at the end of the video, at the end of the show.
Yay.
Okay. Just wanted to highlight it. This next song was requested by Joey. Hi, Joey.
Hi, Joey.
Who I became friends with on Facebook, I think, at one point, and he just bought a beautiful house.
Congratulations.
Never let it ever be said that I don't spend most of my time following you guys around on the internet. Anyway, it's not a happy song, but it's what he requested, and a lot of other people agreed, and it's fun.
Hooray.
Oh, it's okay. Don't mention jerks. Only mention happiness.
Yay.
Okay, sorry. Keep looking at the chat. Stop it. So this is a song that we wrote about stuff.
Great.
Okay, party anthem. Here we go. From Joey. Hi, everybody. Let's do this. It's wonderful to be young. We don't have money, but we still have fun. The night doesn't start till about 3:30. Go to the club or go to the party. You don't like people and you don't want to go, but your friends are here and you forgot to say no. So put on mascara so you look awake. Try to be social till you need a break. There is no reason this shouldn't be fun. There's excitement in the air. We have our whole lives. We have our freedom. I don't care. I don't care.
On we, go. On our own. On we, go. On our own.
Wake up in the afternoon feeling like, why? You could get up or you could just cry. Your friends are happy and you are bitter. Getting jelly when you look at Twitter. You don't want to shower so you stay in bed. Look at your phone and get in your head. Try to get motivated, tell yourself lies. Like you would be happy if you got exercise. It's the weekend, you should see your friends. Anyone, anywhere.
Good job, guys. You're here.
Should you go out?
Yeah, there we go.
Or should you stay in?
Personally, I don't care.
I don't care. On we, go. On our own. On we.
What's the point? What's the point? Okay.
On we.
All right, special guests, click the link, please. We have a very exciting, very special guest.
Yes.
This month, and these are our friends right from here in Portland who have been sort of music performy friends with us since the very beginning.
Yeah.
I remember we meeting them at a bar in a previous iteration of this band. They're wonderful, wonderful humans. Jessica is a scientist and helped us with that song that we mentioned, The Way I Glow. Which was really cool because she's a smart lady with science in her heart and love in her eyes. She got them mixed up at one point and never put them back. I'm going to tweet real quick.
Yay, tweeting. I'm going to dance while you're tweeting. Yeah. They're here.
And they're here. Hello, PDX Broadsides.
Hi, you guys.
Hey. We have a little bit of echo. Give us 2 seconds.
Okay.
Okay. Boom. Boom. Can you hear us?
We can hear you.
We can hear you.
Yay. Hi. Wave to the people. Wave into the camera, you guys.
Hello. That camera.
Up here.
Camera two.
All right. Could you guys introduce yourselves individually and collectively, please?
Yeah. Hi. We are the PDX Broadsides. And I'm Jessica Hebert. Hello.
I'm Christian Lipsky. Hello.
I'm Holly Ann, I'm McCollum. Camera two.
And we make nerdy music about Lego and Star Trek and Nathan Fillion amongst other things. And our moms think we're funny. And some of them are watching in the chat right now. Hi, moms.
Oh, yeah, that's so wonderful. I like that you immediately like to clarify that you do know the plural of Lego. Like, that's just right off the bat an excellent way to show your nerd cred right from the beginning.
We had a band meeting.
Yeah.
Wonderful. Well, thank you so much for joining us. We're going to ask you our standard questions. I'm going to start with one of them, and then we'll do another one in between your two songs, if that's okay.
Yeah.
This first question will go out to each of you individually. If you were a bird, what would be your favorite thing about being a bird?
It would probably be the ability to crash political events and make them all about me. It's probably would be the best thing about being a bird.
Bernie Sanders. Lucia, who's in the chat right now, was at that rally. Were you either of you guys or any of you?
No, I was watching Lucia on Twitter at the rally, though.
We were watching all four friends. It was great.
Yeah, Bernie Sanders was just in Portland. I wasn't here, and a bird came and talked to him, and he did like a whole musical number, like he's a Disney princess.
He's got a good whistle.
Yeah, no, listen, all respect. Anybody who can be a Disney princess is good in my book.
Ooh,
all right, Jessica or Hollyanna?
I like worms.
That's why.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Best thing about being...
The ability to pluck out the eyes of my enemies.
See, this is a great question. You learned so much about people. And I feel like I've known you guys for a few years. Some of these people have just met you, and they know you as well as I do. Just from those three answers.
That's all it took.
All right,
you wasted all that time getting to know us. Sorry.
I know. What was I thinking? All right. Well, please feel free to take off your headphones, play us a song, and then put them back in, and then we'll talk to you a little bit more.
Okay.
Ow. You ready to play a song, you guys?
Yeah. Let's play a song.
Let's do that.
This is a song about street harassment.
Yeah.
Woo. No. No woos. Holly?
Tell us about the song.
Yeah, I wrote this song while waiting for the MAX, the light rail at the 5th and David stop. If you're familiar with Portland, it's
not great.
It's fun place to hang out.
It's not great.
It's called Smile. Maybe you think you're clever, or maybe you think it's cute. But we are just perfect strangers, so you come off like a brute. Just trying to get to work now, so excuse me if I'm not too trite. I've never met you before, sir, and you don't know it, but you're starting a fight. Please don't ask me to smile. Please don't tell me to cheer up. Because this is my face, and it isn't your place to tell me how I should use it. No, don't ask me to smile, because it isn't kind of creepy. I just wanna be me. Every sad and every, and I'm fine with me, so I don't see a need to excuse it. I got a pretty cancerous puppy, and my mom and dad just died. I'm sorry I don't seem happy, but I'll try to look on the bright side. But I lost all my things in that house fire, and I had it cooked in a week. I think my boyfriend's dating the mailman, so my tolerance is reaching its peak. Please don't ask me to smile. Please don't tell me to cheer up. Cause this is my face, and it isn't your place to tell me how I should use it. No, don't ask me to smile, because it isn't kindness, creepy. I just wanna be me. Every Saturday, every and I'm fine with me, so I don't see a need. I don't care if I'm pretty, I don't care if I'm cute, I'm not looking to flirt, I'm no sweetheart to you. You may be funny, and you may be sweet, but right now you kind of sound like a creep. Please don't ask me to smile, please don't tell me to cheer up. Cause this is my face, and it isn't your place to tell me how I should use it. No, don't ask me to smile, because it isn't fun, it's creepy, I just wanna be me. Every sad and every, and I'm fine with me, so I don't see a need to excuse it. My cat was abducted by aliens, and my car is infested with bees.
Bees?
I'll try to remember the good times, like when I got that kidney disease. I'm apparently allergic to coffee, and my sister just got killed by a bear. Seems so distracted, but I just found out I'm losing my hair. Please don't ask me to smile. Please don't tell me to cheer up. Cause this is my face, and it isn't your place to tell me how I should use it. No, don't ask me to smile, because it isn't kind, it's creepy. I just wanna be me. Every sad of every, and I'm fine with me, so I don't see a need to excuse it.
That's the song.
That's the song.
Yay!
Thanks,
guys.
Thanks. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Thanks for playing that. I love the song.
We love that song so much. It's so full of anger.
Yay. This is why we need feminism.
Yes.
Yes.
Saying, you guys. Okay, I have another question for you.
Yeah.
First of all, one of the questions that we ask everybody is how did this happen? What your band? Like what happened? Just like whatever origin story you have compressed. Like tell me a little bit.
During the American Revolution, there was a lot of turmoil. But one man. Alexander Hamilton.
You have two more sentences, so.
We were pirates, and then we weren't anymore, and then he came.
And now we're a band.
There was a lot of happiness and joy feelings for all involved.
Yeah.
Hashtag Hamiltrash.
Step one, Alexander Hamilton. Step two, pirates. Step three, ?
Step four,
PDX Broadsides.
Yeah. Yay. And you guys have that song is on a forthcoming album, is that correct?
Yes. Well, a third coming album, sorry. Number two. our third studio album, we're recording it in April at Opal Studios here in Portland. And we have a name for it, you guys. Are you ready? This is the first time that we're saying the name out loud.
Oh, yes, we're so ready. Let's do it.
Our brand new studio album is called Something Rotten.
Yeah.
So if you're a friend of Hamlet and Shakespeare. If you're a friend of Hamlet, I don't know.
I'm sorry. He's kind of
what is friend of Hamlet a euphemism for? I like that a lot.
But we've been yelling about hashtag Hamilton at each other for a couple of weeks because, this Hamlet goes a little Hamilton. You're going to love it. So, Smile is on it. This next song that we're going to do is on it. Some stuff about Nathan Fillion is on it. Mm-hmm. Astronaut's hymn. Yep. Bunch of other things that we've been working on. And we are so excited to bring Something Rotten to the general.
There aren't actually any songs about Hamlet on the album.
It's weird. It's like maybe it trust issues and not putting trust issues on there.
No, it's mostly just a judgment of the quality of the album in advance. It's really...
I find it very helpful to know what the comment, like the one mean comment is going to be before you put it out there. So you put something on there, you think they think that you don't know already, but you do know. So when it does happen, you're like, I did it.
Yeah.
All right, we have one more question and then we want you to play your last song. And this question is, if you could name a new galaxy, what would you name it?
Oh, that is really good.
That's a lot of pressure.
Mm-hmm.
Because everybody who lives there is going to have to take that.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Archimedes is what I'm naming my pony, so I can't name a galaxy after that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm saving that name. It's special.
That's a tough one.
Alawaya.
What?
Perfect. That's a great galaxy name.
What does that mean? I don't know.
I think it is the name of a galaxy.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
Yeah.
That's for the scientists to decide.
I would name it maybe Galaxy with three X's so everyone looks at it because it's super hot.
Awesome. I like it.
I would call it I would call it pdxbroadsides.com because that's never going to be a bad idea.
Yeah. Excellent. I don't even have to ask what your website is now. It's the name of that galaxy.
Look at the galaxy, man.
Oh, hold on. Also, we love Think Geek clothes. That's a thing. Think Geek is great.
I'll give you an email address. Well, thank you guys so much for joining us. You've got a lot of new fans in the chat. Everybody, please check out pdxbroadsides.com. They are wonderful and fantastic. They do live stream of their rehearsals. They have all of the music on the Bandcamp for you to listen to. Yeah. Go buy all of it. And definitely stay tuned for Something Rotten because it's going to be so good.
Yeah,
all right.
Thank you.
Please introduce us to your next song.
We will. Okay. Headphones off.
Bye.
Okay. Christian, are you ready? This is a song about a girl. This is a song about a girl who's in line in front of you at Starbucks for 45 minutes. And she gets to the front and she still goes, what's good? Do you still have pumpkin spice even though it's April? This is a song about a girl who merges from the non-merging lanes. She don't care. She's from California. This is a song about a girl, Christian.
Yes.
Tell us about the girl.
This song goes way back. It was a song that was written a long, long time ago back in the old country.
Which old country?
Any old country, doesn't matter. This song was written way, way back.
When was it written?
Was written back in 1825, 17.
That is not a year.
It will be. This song, well, all I can say about this song is hold on to your hats, because this is the wildest ride west of the Pequot. This song is called The Girl Who Couldn't Even.
One, two, three.
The girl who couldn't even, she just could not with this. Singing way-ho.
Right, I know.
And she literally almost died.
And she literally almost died.
Her mochaccino's not that hot.
Oh no, I can't even.
That parking ticket costs a lot.
Oh no, I just can't. Sing way-ho.
Right, I know.
Are you kidding me? It's a 40-minute wait for brunch.
Oh no, I can't even.
Boots so small she had to scrunch.
Oh no, I just can't. Sing way-ho.
Right, I know.
Are you kidding me? The girl who couldn't even, she just could not with this. Sing way-ho.
Right, I know.
And she literally almost died.
And she literally almost died.
Leftovers got thrown away.
Oh no, I can't even.
Twitter has been down all day.
Oh no, I just can't. Sing way-ho.
Right, I know.
Are you kidding me?
Nothing could communicate.
Oh no, I can't even.
What she has to tolerate.
Oh no, I just can't. Sing way ho.
Right, I know.
Are you kidding me?
Everybody!
The girl who couldn't even, she just could not with this. Sing way ho.
Right, I know.
And she literally almost died.
And she literally almost died.
And she literally almost died.
And she literally, not even figuratively,
almost
died. Oh my God!
Yay!
Thank you, DoubleClicks.
Thank you, DoubleClicks.
Thank you so much for joining us, everybody. Check out the PDX Broadsides.
Thank you, everybody.
Bye.
Bye. Aren't they the best? They're the best.
The best.
Absolutely the best. Oh, I'm so glad you're all buying their things. They're the best. The best, best, best. Interesting tidbit. There's a picture of us performing with PDX Broadsides and the travel book Moon Guide to Portland. It's true.
There's a new edition out right now.
Oh, it probably doesn't have that picture anymore. But the old one did. So we are officially all combined.
That's right.
A Portland institution.
Yes.
But only went together.
Yes.
Oh man. Time is flying. We're going to keep going for a while now because we have a lot more songs to play.
Yay.
So I hope you'll stay tuned. By the way, hi, Mom and
hi,
Uncle
Mom.
Bob and Aunt Sharon. Thank
hi.
You for tuning in. We have been instructed that you are here. Thanks for tuning in, you guys. Did you see it's Easter here? This egg has a heart. Oh, that's kind of gross.
It's been painted on.
Oh, okay.
These are decorated. Decorative eggs.
Decorative eggs.
Plastic. It's fine. They're actually made of construction paper.
What?
Yep.
Aubrey, you just shattered the entire illusion. People thought these were literal eggs.
I'm sorry.
Yeah. Okay. So let's do some more music. This next song was requested by Natasha.
Yay!
Among other people. It is a song about trains and physics and other stuff.
Yes.
And it's great. We're going to be announcing tour dates later. That's the other thing I wanted to say. Yeah. I just love the PDX Broadsides. If you have a chance to see them, they're just so cheerful and wonderful.
Yes.
As you can tell already.
Amazing
from that
shows.
They're really great. We're just so glad that they still like us. Oh, they've known us so long. All right. How does the song go? Okay, I'm ready, I think. Is everybody okay? I just need to calm down for a second.
It's okay.
Oh, people were liking your... would you like to describe your accessories real quick?
And sure.
How this all goes together.
How this all goes together. This is my galaxy scarf from Zoomies and my Mars rovers on my ears.
Can I see it?
Can I see it? And then I have some star shirt.
Great. And her shoes have stars on them too.
Oh yeah.
Oh, I would have just lifted my foot up and like knocked everything over, but that's why you're
I spent too long putting this together.
The older sister. Way more. Okay, I'm done looking at the chat. Somebody just told me in the chat to stop looking at the chat. That was great. Okay, here's the song.
Ready?
Mm-hmm. I'm a train traveling at 2A plus X, got a cargo of nothing except my effects. My track isn't laid yet. My plan is still blurry, but I'm moving too fast to remember to worry. You're a train at point Y, and you have been for years, held in one spot by your justified fears. You've got some wisdom, trajectory notes, but I don't recall ever seeking your vote. No, you are not my source. I am not your project, 'cause I'm an unstoppable force, and you're an immovable object. I'm an unstoppable force, and you're an immovable object. I'm a train tumbling and making mistakes, but my choices are mine, and that's why I have brakes. Collisions, reversals, I keep scraping by. I'd rather be wrong than forget how to try. I'm a train trying to find my own way. You've got a lot of trite nonsense to say. There are things that I do you think should be addressed, and you say the word proud when you should say impressed. Please get off your horse. This is not your project, 'cause I'm an unstoppable force, and you're an immovable object. I'm an unstoppable force, and you're an immovable object. You've got tips on locations, you've been there before. You think I shouldn't be on my own anymore. I don't want your tips, I don't care that they're free. You've been around, but you've never been me. I'm a train exiting all of known space. Your tracks in circles inside that old rat race. I don't know where we're going, though I certainly care. If I win or I fail, I hope you aren't there. If you were creative, productive, or smart, if you demonstrated you knew how to art, I would listen. But you barely leave your own station. You've only got mass, I've got acceleration. Please get off your horse. You are off this project, 'cause I'm an unstoppable force, and you're an immovable object. I'm an unstoppable force, and you're an immovable object. Please take screenshots and tweet them out, as we need one for the thumbnail for the video. So something funny happens.
Nothing funny's happened so far.
I'm doing it. Is it working? It's never the one you want it to be, but it's always great. Mom, I'm sorry that my bangs are in my eyes. I know I need to get them cut, but in Portland, they don't cut your bangs short enough.
Yeah.
Right?
I mean, I'm not having this problem.
You're just going to contradict me, Aubrey? Speaking of improv and yes anding. Do you guys know I have a podcast that Aubrey's not on because she's terrible?
There's a good reason for that.
I have a podcast called Gosh Darn Fiasco. Aubrey did the music for it and does amazing things with the audio. She's very wonderful. But the podcast is called Gosh Darn Fiasco. It's got Lucia on it along with a lot of our friends. And we improvise just a brand new story for you every 2 weeks, every first and third Monday. And you can check it out at goshdarnfiasco.simplecast.fm or on Twitter/goshdarnfiasco or on your local iTunes at Gosh Darn Fiasco. And we have a really good time and it's super fun. Anyway, plug for that.
It's really funny. It's like, 2 hours of entertainment.
And the thing that makes it funny is that when somebody says something, nobody else immediately contradicts
yeah.
the world that they've created. It's true. I've tried to get people to cut my bangs short and they won't.
I'm sorry.
Aubrey, you're forgiven. Your bangs look great.
Thank you.
I have a different haircut.
You really do.
Also, you're in Beaverton.
Yeah, you're right.
And they have shorter bangs out here.
Oh, okay.
That's the main difference between Beaverton and Portland. I'm gonna take
length of bangs.
Okay. Okay. I'm just going to look at the chat just for a second.
Looking at the chat for a second. Try a second. I'm going to get the song ready. Here we go. Boom.
Mom says we both look fantastic.
Thanks, Mom.
Oh, yeah. Kyle's in the chat. Kyle's also on Gush Darn Fiasco. The last episode of Gush Darn Fiasco is very funny. It's about Seattle.
Yeah.
But really what it's about is me and Kyle competing for how many different characters we can do and how much we can be talking the entire show. And it's really good.
I love it. It's so good. It just keeps climaxing till you guys are playing characters that have accents.
I play a Swedish chef who turns Italian in the middle of speaking.
So good.
It's great.
I basically died laughing.
I just listened to an episode of Spontaneanation.
Yeah.
Where they all lose their accents also. It makes me feel a lot better about it. Okay. All right. Let's get serious. This is our song requested by Paul.
Hi, Paul.
Said, I want you to play Bad Memories because Box Fort, the video for this song, we filmed in a box fort in my room because I never throw away boxes and I have too many boxes. And so we built a fort out of them and wrote a song about childhood and sadness. So,
what do you got? Boxes. Make a set out of it. There. Yeah. Now I'm doing it.
I'm sorry for all the plugs, you guys. Please just... Oh, yeah. That's good.
That's what's happening.
That's nice.
Thank you.
How's everything going, Carrie? Awesome.
See this okay?
Over just a little. There we go.
Cool.
So yeah, this is a song about how why going to therapy is a good idea.
Yeah.
You start thinking about things in a new way, and that's good. All right, so, and it's off of our latest album, is that correct?
It is, President Snakes.
President Snakes. When I was 6, I wore a red and white dress, and the neighbor kids called me Minnie Mouse. But the neighbor kids were the only ones I was allowed to invite to my house. So my friends would be my friends as long as we were not at school, where they treat me like garbage to make them seem cool. And I'm bitter. I'm still a little bit bitter. In middle school, my parents thought I should hang out with kids who weren't so male. And then some girls tried to lock me in the bathroom while they watched Monty Python and the Holy Grail. And after 10 years, most of me has grown up and moved on. But a little bit still wants them to admit that they were wrong. And that's not helping. It's really not helping. I still hear the voices saying that no one likes me. And sometimes I believe them, even now. I can't forget the taste of that pain and that fear, but I dilute those bad memories with more good ones every year. And I'm bitter, but it is over. I spent my high school years overcompensating for my insecurity. That was lame. I burned more bridges than a retreating army. And I was lonely and I had myself to blame. Senior year, my boyfriend told me that my friends didn't really like me. It was all pretend and that hurt. He was kind of a jerk. I try to live my life without regrets, and I try pretty hard to just forget. But it doesn't help me to think about all my young strife. I know I'm great today because of all of that heck, but I think I could have been a happy kid as well and still made something positive out of my life. A
but there's nobody flawless who can pass the first stone. I've got a bucket full of rocks here that are never getting thrown. I still remember the classroom where I made a girl cry. I don't remember how I did it, and I don't remember why. But a bully is a dick, accused of make her feelings blur. And like a snake, she's more afraid of you than you could be of her. And that doesn't make it better. That doesn't make it right. I still hear the voices saying that no one likes me. And sometimes I believe them, even now. I can't forget the taste of that pain and that fear, but I dilute those bad memories and add good ones every year. And I'm sorry. And I'm glad it is over.
Yay! Oh, that hair is so good, Aubrey.
Thank you.
It's really nice.
I'm really happy with it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Everyone agrees that our hair is great.
Okay.
Yay!
Yay!
Thank you for that request, Paul.
Thank you, Paul, and everybody. Somebody just said that somebody reminds them of Liz Lemon. I'm hoping it's me. Have you guys seen Whiskey Tango Foxtrot? Okay, let's move on. It's good. It's a good movie.
So many people in that movie.
Yay, a wild applause has appeared. Thank you, guys. We got more things. Yeah, of course President Snakes is afraid of you guys. I don't need to build up that part of the canon. It's pretty clear. She's terrified. All right, so we've got another relatively old song. This was requested by Jay and a bunch of people on Facebook.
Can I have the computer?
Oh, Aubrey needs the computer.
My computer's not behaving, so I'm just going to work with it.
Oh, okay. You should pause that because it's going to start making the noise.
Thank you.
Of the video.
Great.
Yeah, okay. Cool. Yeah, so relatively old song. This was the first song that our cat keyboard Max appeared on ever, which is kind of exciting.
True fact.
True FAQ. I like it. It's a song about Portland. It's actually a song about a real person who I'm pretty sure knows that the song is about him. No, he doesn't. Oh, no, he doesn't at all. Okay. Is that all? Okay. I can't see the chat anymore, so I have nothing to get distracted by. Is everything going okay?
It's going to be great.
Cool.
I'm just going to get through it.
We're just going to get through it. And then right after this one, we will be doing the tour announcement. And if you have any questions, drop them in the chat and Carrie will tell us about it. And mostly just talk to each other. And don't, I was going to say don't ask her mom any questions, but she wouldn't know how to use the computer anyway. So everything is fine. She does. She's a smart lady. And this is a song about hipsters.
Yep.
But you know, I recognize that I am wearing two pairs of thick rim glasses right now. So obviously it's pretty self-referential, but it's also about like true things. So like, don't be offended because it's like my story. And yeah.
You ready for the drum machine?
I'm ready for, oh yeah, we used a drum machine on this.
Yep.
So many years ago.
So many years ago.
All right, I'll hit it.
Here we go.
Yeah. It had a name too. A drum machine. Is it Jeff?
Your jeans are way too tight and your sweatshirt's got a Christmas tree. Under that's a full back tattoo of your powder blue fixie. And it's not because you like these things, it's a joke only hipsters see. I wish I'd known you looked at love with that same philosophy. I have been such a fool, how did I not see that you only love me ironically? You like my nerdy glasses? Well, I need them to see. And it's not a matter of image that I got a job at the library. No, I actually like Star Trek. That was not supposed to be funny. And And I'm not pretending when I act like I don't have any money. I have been such a fool, how did I not see that you only love me ironically? This realization came after a time of great reflection. Noticing all you own and do has a strange off-tilt perfection. How do I fit in to your ugly stuff obsession? I am just an accessory in your irony collection. I have been such a fool, how did I not see that you only love me ironically? I'm not going to tell you I'm leaving. It is long past time to desert. And I can't look into the sad, sad eyes of the kittens on your t-shirt without any real feelings. I know you won't be hurt. Call me up if you find the real world and finally want to convert. I have been such a fool, how did I not see that you only love me ironically?
There's no more music that we're dancing.
They don't know that. Maybe they think we think there's music. Okay, are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? I think you are. Because we have a giant tour this summer. We're calling it the Massive Tour, and that's not because we think it's the biggest tour that's ever happened, but it is related to the fact that we have two new songs about mass and science. So this is going to be the Massive Tour. It's very exciting. We're going on a drive across the country. There are not all of the dates are announced yet or planned. Like, we're going to add a West Coast leg also later. So don't be disappointed if you are you don't see your dates. But I'm going to show you this image right now.
Yay! Very exciting.
Uh-oh.
The excitement.
That has the dates.
Yay!
Share.
Look at all those dates.
Is it working? Present to everyone.
So many dates.
Yeah. Okay. So we're going to be in Salem, Oregon. We're playing a show at the library, which is exciting. Uh-oh. Oh,
this you can push play.
I see what happened. This is frozen. Please come to Portland, Christian. You. You butt of a butt. I don't want to swear. Yeah, we're going to be playing two kids shows in Portland area. Well, I guess Salem's not really Portland area, but also Tualatin, Oregon. So, yay!
Yay!
We're going to Fort Collins. We're going to Iowa City. We've never been to Iowa before. We've never been to Fort Collins before. Coming back to Minneapolis after 2 years. Going back to Milwaukee, the 42 Ale House. Tickets are already available for that one. That's cool. Going back to Madison, Wisconsin. We're playing in Chicago finally again. We're going to Kentucky for the first time. Did you guys know we're from Kentucky? We are. We're going to be in, Cincinnati, Ohio. Finally going back to Ohio again.
Yeah.
Twice in 1 year. Toronto, Ontario. We're going to Boston. That's an afternoon show. We're trying to get an all-ages show ready in Boston also because the goal of this is to do all-ages shows everywhere. We'll be in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. We find a place to play, but even though Melody's closed, which is very sad. We'll be in New York. We're finally doing our first all-ages show in New York, which is very exciting.
Wow.
Then we'll be going back to Brooklyn, our old regular place there. Vienna, Virginia, of course, Norfolk, Virginia, which we had an amazing show at a few years ago.
Yes.
We're going back to Mystery Brewing in Hillsboro, North Carolina, with Juliana Finch, who is also going to be playing with us in Atlanta, Georgia. Orlando, Florida, we're playing with Mark with a C.
Mark with a C.
New Orleans, our very first show in that state. The state of New Orleans, yes. Three shows in Texas, Phoenix. We're coming back to Portland, doing a huge show at the Doug Fur with Daniel at the Sandwich, and more things. So
good.
I do hope you will come to those shows. I hope you will look up the stuff. Not all of the dates are announced, but there is a link in the description of this video to sign up for our mailing list, where we will send out all of the stuff. Not all the shows will have tickets. A lot of it is like pay at the door kind of situation. So just show up. Please mark your calendar with those dates and come see us. Oh, Doc wants to come in.
Hi, Doc. No.
Oh, yeah, PAX East. I don't know if we were supposed to announce that. So that's just between us, you guys. Yeah, we're hoping to be at PAX East. We're going to, we are definitely going to be at PAX East. We're doing a live gosh darn fiasco at PAX East, which is going to be awesome. Aubrey's going to be on that along with Chris Straub and Graham Stark. Aubrey's going
to
do,
say and.
We're going to train her up.
And,
yes, and.
And I'm going to be on the panel, and it's going to be great.
Improv jokes. and we've got a lot of amazing stuff coming up. So we're really, really excited about that tour. We get to go to a lot of places we don't normally go when we do this big, long driving tour, which will be exhausting. We're hoping there will be juggling at every show because we're bringing along this person who I'm going to convince that to call himself our tour manager, who's also going to juggle.
Perfect.
Yeah, it's going to be great.
I'm going to make a juggling playlist.
So everybody, please.
There's going to be juggling and
just tweet.
Music
I can't
juggling.
Wait for the juggling on the DoubleClicks tour. Just tweet that
massive
and then
tour.
The DoubleClicks massive tour. We need to get a hashtag, but just we'll make it happen if we all believe. Peer pressure is the way that I make things happen because I'm a good friend. Okay. We have, these are the jokes. Yay.
Yay. We're so excited to see your faces in person. And yeah. We hope we're going to see you wherever you are. We come to you, not just in your computer screen. We'll be in 3D.
In 3D. We will have costumes. We will play songs.
Yes.
It will be very fun.
Yay.
The goal is that we will be able to take some requests before shows. If there's a song you absolutely want to hear, we absolutely want to play it if we have enough notice.
Yes.
Yeah, stuff like that. It's going to be great. Yes, I'm real jazzed. I'm real jazzed. So this next song is a song about touring. And it's a positive song about touring. I don't know. Somebody suggested it. Who did it?
Who was it?
Ryan Taylor said,
thanks, Ryan.
He requested this song because apparently the life of a cis admin is not that different than the life of a rock star or something like that. And I was like, that sounds great. I don't know what you're talking about, but I'm in. So we're going to play this song for you. The song we read about touring on the last time we did one of these giant tours.
Yes.
And then we filmed the video. We filmed the video in Aubrey's car driving around, and Aubrey drove a stick, and it was in this horrible horrible neighborhood to be driving a stick. So I'm a big fan of that video just because I remember how terrible it was trying to do it. So you should watch
that. No one was harmed in the making of that video.
No, absolutely not.
It's a great video.
It was just challenging.
It was a good challenge.
And we are up for a challenge. DoubleClicks. We're going to play a few more songs. Thanks for staying tuned to the DoubleClicks live show. We're having a good time with you. You're all very funny. Stop looking at the chat.
Yay.
That was just me.
Thank you. I needed
scaring Aubrey into being ready to play. That's going to be one of the important parts of GDF is just constant vigilance for us to just throw something at you without any warning or any polite.
I'm pretty okay at improv on my chill. I just need to get it into the speaking.
We need to tell you that it's going to happen.
Yeah, let me know.
Yeah, you could just play your cello on GDF.
I could.
That'd be kind of cool.
Yeah.
Let's talk about that.
Okay.
All right, here we go. I rolled initiative. Oh, I can take these off.
You can.
Woo. I rolled initiative when I woke up today, and I didn't do that well, but I had to get up anyway. Our ride was in the parking lot. A rental car so new, and we drove and drove and drove and drove and drove and drove some too. We played a show for people, and we shook a lot of hands, and we role-played in this game we call Successful Touring Band. In the evening I crawled into bed at 10 or 12 or 2, and I wish that I was coming home to you. We ate Chipotle for the second time for dinner. It was not the only option, but man, it was a winner. In the car we sang along to Katy Perry and Pharrell until the radio was static, and then we got to the hotel. We sent a lot of emails, and we made a lot of plans, and we role-played in this game we call Successful Touring Band. In the evening I crawled into bed at 10 or 12 or 2, and I wish that I was coming home to you. Don't say that I don't love this life. You would be wrong.
because every show is wonderful, though every day is long, and when the energy from meeting all those awesome nerds is through, I just wish that I was coming home to you. In the future, I will teleport, till then I will make do, and I'll wish that I was coming home to you.
We did it.
Yay, we did it.
How many songs do we have left? We have two more songs left.
Two songs. Count them two.
Count them two. Count them two. Oh gosh, I have so many plugs, you guys. We're very busy, and I'm sorry if this is too much to remember. But on April 4th, so we've been talking a lot about 5 years of the Doubleclicks. It's been 5 years since we started the band, which is cool and it's fun to think about. We did a great, big, super long, wonderful, very in-depth interview where we talked about a lot of stuff we haven't talked about before with nerdy.fm. And they're going to be broadcasting that on April 4th at 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 p.m. Pacific, other times, other places. I put a link in the description here. We're planning to be on the internet while that's streaming. There's a hashtag. I think the hashtag is DoubleClicks Evening because it's called an evening with the DoubleClicks. Pretty sure. If you want to talk to us about stuff, if you're interested in us as people or us as a band, we've got a lot of things that we don't normally talk about. We're on there, and it was really fun. We were interviewed by Lauren, who is the fifth sister, and Mark with the C, who are both amazing nerd musicians. So it was really cool to talk to people who knew what they were talking about and could relate to stuff. And I had a good time. I had a really good time.
Yeah, it was awesome. It was maybe one of our longest interviews.
Yeah, definitely our best interview that was that long, and definitely one of our longest interviews. I think it will be edited for air.
Still,
you'll have a lot of information. I think Lauren might be in the chat able to answer your questions about that. If you're not familiar, by the way, nerdy.fm, 24-hour nerd music streaming, I want to say. Like, they have shows, and Lauren and Mark are in charge of it. And it's really, if you like nerd music and you're looking for more, check that out. Just put it on at work and stuff, because they have an amazing service and they work hard on it. And it's groovy.
Yeah.
Groovy, groovy stuff. Discover new bands, support them with your ear holes.
Yeah.
Okay. We have two more songs. This next song goes out to Meredith, who I know is a scientist.
Meredith!
It's dedicated also to Aubrey's earrings.
Thank you.
And to President Snakes. And it's a song about the Mars rover.
Yay!
I'm just gonna look at this real quick. Aubrey, dance.
Dancing and dancing, it's dancing time because she's looking at the chat. Boom.
I think somebody asked, edited due to content. I think the interview was mostly edited from when I started making fun of Mark or making him uncomfortable because I am a misandrist. No, because it was fun. It was really, really fun. We got to talk about the questions and stuff. I really liked that interview. I hope you will listen if you are interested, and if not, just totally don't. It's totally fine. But. Oh, yeah, and I'm supposed to plug the fact that we have a Patreon, which funds this video and makes it possible.
Thank you, patrons.
It makes us able to pay the PDX Broadsides for appearing on this and make other things. If you go to patreon.com/theDoubleClicks, you can pledge. And if this show is worth a dollar to you, you can go give us a dollar for this show.
Thank you.
That'd be cool. And they also get sneak previews of a lot of stuff that we don't release anywhere else, which is pretty fun. And we have a new video coming out for Patreon backers in the next few days. Aubrey covered the Star Wars opening theme. What's it called?
Yeah. Opening theme.
On the cat keyboard. So.
You're welcome.
That's for real. And that's coming. And it is ridiculous. So I hope you will check that out. I could show them, but I don't think the sound would work. So never mind. Okay. So.
Stuff to look forward to.
Something to look forward to. Subscribe to our YouTube. Oh, yes, that's the other thing. I'm sorry I have to talk so much. This is the right time for you to all press the thumbs up button if you like this video. That helps us a lot on YouTube because we really shouldn't be doing monthly shows on YouTube because it borks our SEO or something. But if you press thumbs up, that will help us a lot, and we appreciate it.
Thank you.
I hope that's the screenshot.
Yep.
I hope that's it.
It's going to be great.
All right. So this is a song about the Mars Science Laboratory and also feelings. Here we go.
feels like I've held my breath for hours. And I turn on my eyes to find I'm very far away. I take account of all my wheels, my arm, and my tiny drill. After all my training, I will do nothing familiar today. The folks who brought me up for this have such high expectations. And though they shouldn't, they have dared to dream that I can change it all. Thousands watch as I turn on my camera and do my first job. I feel so important and so very small. All I can think is of the ways I'll disappoint them. I've got the tools, I've got the team, but I'm not ready for my close-up. Everybody trusts me more than I do, and I still don't feel like I've even grown up. But I am faking it. I'm just pretending I can do this. I am faking it. I am faking it on Mars. They're all watching me, and I don't know if I can take the next few steps. With every ticking second, some of my confidence disappears. Out here it is cold, it is lonely, and I am far from home. What would Hubble say if she were only here? And the worst part is not knowing what will greet me. I represent my planet, but I'm really not prepared. I hope that I have time to ask for all the help I need. And I hope if I find aliens, I won't act too scared. But I am faking it. I'm just pretending I can do this. I am faking it. I am faking it on Mars.
Yay, thank you. Yay, oh yay, people saying this is their favorite DoubleClick song.
Oh my gosh, thank you so much.
Thank you. I'm a big fan of the song also. Song's called Imposter. It's on our album Lasers and Feelings.
Yes. Lasers and Feelings.
If you want. I don't plug our albums, so buy one if you want. Okay, we've got one more song. If we didn't play the song you wanted, or you maybe want to plus to play a different song, or at some point you have songs, if you go right now to the Facebook link event, which is in the description of this video, our next show is April 16th. It's a Saturday at the same time.
Yes.
And we will be playing basically the top voted songs. So you have to go to discussion on the Facebook page. There's a poll there. Please go tell us what songs that you like would like us to hear to play saying a song.
We want to play the songs you want to hear. Please go to the discussion on the Facebook event page group. I'm helping.
Words. Please send help. Okay, everybody. We're the DoubleClicks. Thank you so much for tuning in to DoubleClicks Live. Check out the PDX Broadsides. Obviously, if you get one thing out of this, it's go buy the DoubleClicks or the DoubleClicks Broadsides. The PDX Broadsides stuff. They're wonderful. They're fantastic people. We love them very much. They've got lots of shows, and they deserve your love.
Yes.
And their new album's going to be so good.
It's gonna be so good.
I can't even, you guys.
They write such good songs.
They write so... I literally almost die. You know, I just can't with this.
No.
Please don't ask me this one. So this is our last song. Yay, calendar.
Am I wrong with this?
No. Okay, you're fine. Okay, cool. This song was requested by a bunch of people, including Benjamin Peck, Randy Lee Harper, who was saving our life with
Randy,
her amazing bots, and Monet. A bunch of other people requested this, one of our top voted songs for this show. So thank you for requesting songs, everybody who did. This song is a song about being uncomfortable in public. I met a great cat in Denver. Her name was Alice, and she was so uncomfortable the whole time we were there and just stared at us with the most fear I have ever seen in a creature's eyes. And it was just amazing. And then by the end, I got to play with her. And by that, I mean, she was sitting under the couch I was sitting on, and she would push the little bouncy ball out, and then I'd push it back under, and then she'd push it out again.
Yay!
It was like basically like being best friends. And I love her, and she was not afraid of me by the end, and we became very good friends, and now we're pen pals, and we're gonna be friends forever.
I like this cat.
Oh, yeah, and there's some cats here.
Yep. Ginny Breeden drew this picture of
cats. A girl named Cat colored that.
Yay.
All right, I'm ready, Aubrey.
Here we go.
I'm gonna tell you what you need to party right. It's the new craze, it's the way every night. Put your pants on and drive up to the party house and suddenly remember that you don't like going out. Yeah, you're still a weirdo. Well, imagine that. Here is your solution. Go and find the host's cat. Hanging with cats at parties. Party parties, it's the new movement. Why don't you join me? We don't want your judgment and we don't need your pity. This is where I wanna be, hanging out with cats at parties. Walk into the party like, no thanks, I'll keep my coat. Ending conversations with a nice Taylor Swift quote and saying things like, I don't like local beer. Scanning every corner for the reason you are here. There is a cat, so I'm not technically alone now. Don't tell me to smile, I'm in my comfort zone now. Yes, I'm having fun, I don't need a drink. This is way more comfortable than you probably think, so. Hanging with cats at parties. Party parties, it's the new movement. Why don't you join me? We don't want your judgment and we don't need your pity. This is where I wanna be, hanging out with cats at parties. A cat is not a bigot or a sexist. A cat could care less if you even exist. Unless you're giving it treats, it will just stare at you, and that's the kind of friend I want. What can I do? Our numbers grow out of nowhere like mitosis. We're all slowly contracting toxoplasmosis. We don't need your shame, our life is better cause it's lame. And tonight's just about one thing. Hanging with cats at parties. Party parties, it's the new movement. Why don't you join me? We don't want your judgment and we don't need your pity. This is where I wanna be, hanging out with cats at parties. Hanging out with cats at parties. Hanging out with cats at parties.
That's our show, everybody. Thank you so much for tuning in. We'll see you around the internet.
Yay!
Push the button, Frank. Push the button.